I was someplace a few years ago, and we heard a group had been on a mission trip, and I felt like in my heart that I wish I had went on that trip, and I didn't. And I told myself, you make deals with God, and I told myself if I ever got an opportunity to go somewhere, that I would go. So when this trip came up, I thought, well, great, Africa. Well, I was thinking about somewhere a little closer. Never, don't know anything about Uganda. Never had the desire to go there. And it worked out to go, and I'm grateful for the experience. But when we were getting ready to leave, I just kept finding all these reasons not to go. Financial reasons, responsibilities at home, just on and on and on. And one after another, God worked it out, and I was able to go. And when I got there, I was really worried about, well, what are we going to do here? I work for myself, and if you work for yourself, you have results. You want results. And I go there, and we're going to do some construction, and we're going to witness to some people, and we're going to do some stuff like that. And I thought, well, this is great. We're going to do a great, mighty thing for God. But when we get there, the plans change and stuff changes. And I spent about 2 days thinking, why in the world are we even here? We're not accomplishing anything. We're not doing anything. And we got to witness to people. We talked to people in the village. People were saying that's great. If one of them got saved, that made it worthwhile. But I'm thinking, when's the big moment? What's going to happen? And I saw a lot of moments there. When we built stuff there, when we worked with the people that were building stuff there, they knew more about what they had to do than we did. And I kept looking at what they were doing, and I'm thinking, my gosh, that would never fly at home. How in the world can they get by with this? And then I can't even, the examples of stuff that we saw. We saw a guy wire a welder in hot. I mean, he had no plug in, he had no nothing. And it was sketchy to say the least, but I'm thinking this is dangerous. Why is he doing it this way? Well, he was doing it that way because that's all he had, and he had to do something, and that was his job. And so I came away, and we were going to help the guy fix this thing. And when we got there, he knew more about what he was fixing than we did. It was on a different level. He knew what he was doing, so we weren't able to help him much. We encouraged him. And then we met with some kids one night. I call them kids over, what, 20, early 20s, 18, 19? It passed. And they were the children's and youth minister at the Benjamin House Church. And these kids were so on fire for God. They were so on fire. And we got to spend, 4 hours, 5 hours, maybe more. Some other people, Scott mostly, and Jody and Ryan, and Tim. It was a blessing to me. Just to get to see, and it wasn't that I learned anything. I didn't know. It was just a blessing to see these people, these kids, so on fire for God. And when I went there, I thought, well, if we can do something to help somebody there, this is a great thing. And about the second to the last day, it hit me. I've seen all this stuff wrong here. I see they don't have anything. They live in dirt on the dirt floor. Conditions are horrible, but it hit me, and maybe I should feel this way, but I thought, who's better off? Is it the guy on the dirt floor in Uganda that comes to Christ and there's nothing between him and Christ? Or is it the person here who goes to church every Sunday and sits in air conditioning and prays for people that go on a mission trip or gives to go on a mission trip maybe, but their faith stops there? These people live their faith every day. It was a messed up place. I'm grateful that we got the opportunity to go there and spend some time with the people that we did there, because they're in good hands. If you ask yourself, why should you go, or why should you do something like this? One thing I've noticed is since I came home from there, I've had a platform that I can speak to other people about Christ that I didn't have before, because I have complete people that I just barely know come up and they're like, hey, how was your trip? And I've got that opportunity right then to tell them. And I could share the gospel with them right there. So if I didn't get anything out of going to the trip, if you gone and didn't get nothing out of Cold Shaw on the trip, I got that so a few people have come up to me and said, you know, what you doing on your trip? Well, right then I've got an opportunity to share Christ with them that I didn't have before. So I think everybody here for everything was done to facilitate this trip. And I just appreciate it. Appreciate your time tonight.